actively trying to go against God. Pag wicked talaga, it's like, alam mo na, na ayaw to ni God. And it's something that goes against the standards. Pero ginagawa mo pa din. Yeah, I okay, medyo gets ko na. Gets ko.
Yeah. Amazing, no? So parang those who know that they're doing the wrong thing, they're going against God actively. Tapos meron ding they don't even know it, pero they're actually going against God and His goodness. Possible,
oh,
no?
And
possible.
Sometimes we just can't help it, eh? Diba? We fall into sin. We know it's against God, pero sometimes we just can't help it. I think that's evil. Like yung nature lang ng ano, ng heart natin. Yeah.
Kasi ang context kasi nito, it's about persecutors kasi eh. Be delivered from evil and wicked people. So I think yung mga persecutors, some of them, they really, in a sense, siguro they knew the truth, no? Pero they still persecuted them. Pero yung iba, they don't even know it, pero they're actually going against God. Siguro Paul would be part of that, no? He would be part of that category na parang hindi niya nga alam, pero actually, yun pala ang ginagawa niya. So it was zeal for God, but not according to righteousness.
Yeah.
As he said in Romans. Yeah. Verse 3, but... Meron ka pang ano, i-share? Tijin?
No, wala. I'm just agreeing. Thank you.
So verse 3, but the Lord is faithful and He will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. So, one, there's a shift from wicked and evil people to an evil one. Oo nga, no? Hindi ko yan na-notice. He shifts from wicked and evil people to an evil one. Which is, in a sense, parang the source, no, of the evil. Maganda yung sinabi ni Vody Bakam na tatlo talaga yung kalaban natin. It's the devil, the flesh, and the world. The devil, yung the evil one. The flesh, which is our sinful nature, our inclinations to go against God. Our habits, our brief mga, you know, mga patterns of thinking and feeling and acting that are against God. And the world, which is a culture, basically the combined habits and mindsets of individuals that are opposed to God and His people. So there's a shift from evil people or the world, you can say, or the flesh to an evil one. So is the evil one? Probably it's Satan. You know, baka Antichrist, pero yun na nga. Hindi rin kasi, parang na-state kasi na hindi pa siya dumating. Number two, being there to strengthen and protect them from the evil one. So ang question is, what does it mean to be faithful? So in this context, yung faithfulness ni God is His being there, His presence, and His assurance of strengthening and protecting them from Satan. Verse 4, we have confidence in the Lord that you are doing and will continue to do the things we command. Observation dito is Paul was confident in the Lord that the Thessalonians were obedient to their commands. Amazing ito for me kasi grabe no, confident talaga si Paul. I mean, oo nga in the Lord, pero confident talaga siya no na nag-o-obey talaga sila. Kasi you know, wala pang cameras during this time, di ba? Hindi nila pwede i-video sarili nila, bigay ng hi guys, ganun. Hi Paul, ito pa lang ginagawa namin. Oh, tinan mo, nag-obey pa rin kami. So, he didn't see them talaga, no? Pero siguro, during the time na he was with them, he really saw their willingness to obey. Tapos siguro may nag-report din sa kanya na galing doon sa Thessalonica, saying how, parang reporting to Paul, gaano ka-faithful and obedient yung mga Thessalonians. Paul was confident in the Lord that the Thessalonians were obedient to their commands. The question dito is, why confidence in the Lord and not on the Thessalonians? And what did Paul command? I think both of these, ikaw ba, Jean, ang nagtanong nito?
Yeah, I think tayo lang yung nagsusulat.
Ay, hindi ka ba nagsulat, Jen?
Kuya, really, ko ka-open. Kung laptop, hinay po kay signal sa koan.
Ah, okay, okay. No probs. So, Ate Jean, any hypothesis lang? Or, Jen, why do you think na ang ilahang confidence kay na sa Ginoo, not on the Thessalonians?
Why in the Lord?
Yeah.
Well, maybe because actually hindi ko din alam. But I think kasi that that if the Lord truly was working in the hearts of these Thessalonians, then I think that's something that Paul could actually rely on, that because the thought that maybe the thought of God working in their hearts, or the thought that God is working in their hearts, that and in that he has confidence na gagawin talaga nila yung pinapagawa sa kanila, something like that.
Tricky siya na question, why confidence in the Lord?
Diba?
Tapos, what did Paul command? Siguro ang isa sa mga gi-command ni Paul is yung
prayer ba? Or something else? Ah, yun, don't be idle. Okay.
Marami siguro. Pero ito kasi yung intro niya eh, before siya nag-miratrasan siya ng huwag kayo maging tamad. So, sige lang, we'll see sa ano. May the Lord direct your hearts into God's love and Christ's perseverance. In other versions, it's actually steadfastness.
Oh.
Right? Steadfastness.
So in the same way that Christ is steadfast and Christ is persevere, Paul is hoping that they would also be that they would also display that same steadfastness and be diligent or work with their hands. Yun ba ibig sabihin nun?
Meron dito, 2 Thessalonians 3:5, endurance in adherence to an object. Ano yung object? Endurance. The endurance of Christ. Siguro yung ano, ang alam ko kasi dito, si Jesus kasi nag-endure siya to death, di ba? Namatay siya. And, you know, for the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, despising his shame, and is now seated at the right hand of the throne of God. In the same way, yung Thessalonians kasi they were undergoing through severe persecution. So maybe he was praying to God na ma-direct yung ano nila sa pagmamahal ni Lord into the endurance of Christ would be in them. They would focus their hearts or their eyes or their minds on God's love and the endurance of Christ, no na. The endurance that Christ displayed for them.
Mm-hmm.
By dying for them, suffering for them, and they would fix their hearts or their spiritual eyes on God's love. And again, this is actually yung verse 5, as they focus their hearts on God's love and the endurance that Christ did for them, it's Paul is preparing them for the harsh commands na bibigay niya, di ba? Kasi you need God's love and the endurance of Christ to exhort them na hindi maging tamad, no? And to work night and day. See, this is a harsh command. And I think, I really believe na Paul really loved these people. So, kailangan niya ini-highlight na focus on God's love when you and the endurance of Christ, and as you do that, you will be able to keep away from these brothers na taman. You would be able to, you know, in a way parang excommunicate them, no, or parang this fellowship, tanggalin sila sa community of believers, which is kind of harsh, no, pero that's why they needed to focus on God's love. Because you love these people, kaya mo yun gagawin para mahiya sila, they would be ashamed, and that they would start to actually work for their food, no, and provision. Anyway, that's it. May gusto mo ba kayo i-share before tayo mag-open ng commentaries?
Open mo na.
We'll start na lang siguro with verse B agad. Actually, meron, maganda rin man yung mga scenario ng iba. Pero, diretso kasi si ano eh. Verse B. Tapos magawa na siguro tayo ng exegetical idea. So share the truth. And sequence of responsibility is logical. Learning and living must go together. Where's been the best? The best. Learning and living must go together. If we believe the truth, it changes our lives. We guard the truth and practice it so that we can share it with others. We cannot share what we do not believe, unless we want to be hypocrites. And we can best share that which we have practiced ourselves. Kaya, habits are very important. God's word is alive, and we must let it move freely. Paul alluded here to Psalm 147:15. He sent forth his commandment upon the earth. His word runneth very swiftly. So, dito ko lang na-discover na nag-allude pala si Paul, no, nung when he said that. God's servants may be bound, but God's word cannot be bound. As you practice the truth and pray for the ministry of the truth, God's word will have freedom to run and accomplish God's purpose in the world. So, kailangan natin i-practice yung katotohanan and to also pray for the ministry of God's word, no? So that it would have freedom to run even to the unreached places and unreached peoples. The word of God is glorified in the lives of those who share it and those who receive it. This what was Paul's experience in Antioch of Pisidia, and when the Gentiles heard this, that they could be saved, they were glad and glorified the word. As many as were ordained to eternal life believe. And the word of the Lord was published, spread abroad throughout all the region. Too much Christian work these days is accomplished by human plans and promotion, and not by the word of God. We trust our programs and do not publish the word of God. The universe was created and is sustained by the word of God. Surely his word can accomplish his work in this world. But the preaching of the word in the pulpit has too often been replaced by the entertainment of the world on the platform. Dr. Donald Kogan, Archbishop of Canterbury, said of Christian pastors, "It is their task to feed the sheep, not to entertain the goats." To feed the sheep, not entertain the goats. It's been my experience in three pastors that God's word will accomplish God's work. When the sheep are fed, they will flock together in love, reproduce, follow the shepherd, and they can be fleeced and beloved. It's when the sheep are hungry that they start biting each other. Ito talaga. When the sheep are hungry, they start biting each other, they become sick, and they start wandering away. When the word of God does the work, then God gets the glory. My good friend Dr. Babu used to remind us, if you can explain what is going on, then God isn't doing it. Of course, there's always opposition to the word and work of God. Paul asked his friends to pray that he might be delivered from unbelieving men who are evil and wicked. Just as the Spirit uses dedicated people to share the word, Satan uses wicked people to oppose the word. The evil one enjoys using Christian believers to oppose the work of God. He spoke through Peter and he worked through Ananias and Sapphira. Paul had confidence that his readers would not yield to Satan, but would permit the faithful Lord to establish them and guard them from the evil one. We cannot have confidence in ourselves, but we can have confidence in God for ourselves and for others. It's not enough that the pastor or church officers alone share the word. Each Christian must be a part of this vital ministry. The word command that Paul used in 2 Thessalonians 3:4 means a military order passed down from a superior officer. He used this word in 1 Thessalonians 4:2 and he repeated it in 2 Thessalonians. Now, I really love this, no? Command is actually a military order passed down from a superior officer. Hindi pala siya, hindi siya parang optional talaga. Like, you really have to do it. Now, Christ is the captain of our salvation and we are his soldiers. In the battle, it is not enough for only the officers to fight. Every man must do his duty. This is also true in the work of the local church. What if an army, ito, I really love this. Talagang swak talaga siya no, sa Filipino Christian context and maybe the Western church no, in general. What if an army were run with the same lack of obedience, order, and discipline that we often see in the local church? It would never win. The war, court-martialed, no? Pwede nga patayin yung mga court-martial, pinapatayin yung mga hindi nag-o-obey sa commands of the superior officer. And this reminds me sa shinare ni Alex, no? One of
hello? Nawala ka, Ben.
Captain, the Lord Jesus Christ. A soldier obeys primarily out of loyalty and fear. But a Christian has much higher motives for obedience. God's love and Christ's return. Sabi pa ni Jesus, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. Commanding officer does not require his men to love him, but if they do, they will respect and obey him with greater diligence. The history of warfare records heroic deeds done by men who loved their leaders and willingly died for them. Our Savior loved us and died for us. Why cannot we obey him? Jesus is coming for us. This has been the theme of Paul's two letters to the Thessalonians, and he related this truth to everyday practical living. As God's soldiers, we must be sharing the word, for he will one day return and ask for an accounting of our lives. Do we love his appearing? Will we be ashamed before him at his coming? Here then are four great responsibilities for us to fulfill. Believe the truth, guard the truth, practice the truth, and share the truth. If we fulfill these duties, we will experience joy and power in our lives and growth and blessing in our churches. Sige. So, at this point, mag-ano na tayo, mag-gawa na tayo ng exegetical and homiletical idea natin. I'll give 17 minutes na lang for that. Yan, inunahan ako ni Ate Jean. Yan na ba yun? Attention. Identical idea. Reflection. Yan lang, lagay na lang natin dito. Obed, Jean. Jens, kumakatayad ka Ate Jens, no? Or you can just put it sa, ano, sa
chat box na lang guro ko ya din.
Yeah, copy-paste na lang. Balik lang. Kain mo na ako. Gutom na talaga. Anyway, we'll start discussing 8:40. Tapos yung ano, yung application as much as possible, guys, ano natin, gawa pala tayo ng ano, Google Sheets for application. So smart talaga. Lagyan natin ng deadline. Tapos next week, tingnan natin kung nagawa ba natin. So, ang format for application, sigyan ko na lang ng ano. Based ito again sa ano, sa Atomic Habits. Kasi grabe, by God's grace, talagang nag-change ang life ko, no? When I tried to apply it. So, let's make it into a may term yun, implementation intention, I think, yung term. So, ang format is, I will behavior at in a place at date and time. So for example, I will share the gospel in Dulian on Thursday, 3 p.m. Parang ganun. So dapat very specific siya. Tapos, gagawa na lang tayo ng Google Sheets to check if nagawa ba talaga natin yun, no? Tapos, we can pray also for each other this week na magawa natin. As much as possible, let's do it this, parang yung application niya is this week para ma-check talaga natin, no? Parang from Wednesday to Monday. BRB.
Jensen, ang ganda ng ano mo, mathematical idea mo. Lalang.
Yun, nag-come across sa mind ko after hearing the explanations. Ang ganda ng komentaryo ni Kuya Obed yung sa last part.
Mm-hmm. Sa reflection, wala ka?
I'm fighting pa ako, ate.
Ah, sige. Ah, babalik lang ako.
Sure, ate.
Diyan na, meron na nga na si Ate si Jensen.
Hello. Ako na lang yung nag-face for her.
Oh, wala pa akong nalagay. Sige, mauna na lang muna kayo, Ate Jean, mag-share.
I mean, mag-type ka na.
Oo, oh, nag-aisip pa ako.
Kumopya ka na lang. It's okay.
Okay. Meron lang yan. Mamaya. Pagkatapos mo magsalita, pati ni Jensen, mag-share lang din ako sa akin.
Ano? Okay. Ano, Jen? Sino sa atin mauna?
Basahin mo muna.
Go, Ate Jean.
No. Binolunteer ako. Well, ayun. Well, seeing that it's very straightforward naman, medyo straightforward din yung ano ko. Yung mga nasulat ko for the exegetical idea, melatical idea, pati nga yung reflection, sobrang simple na. So, ayun. I write here that Paul writes that he is confident in the Lord's faithfulness and that he will direct the Thessalonians' hearts into steadfastly following him. So, homiletical idea, God strengthens, protects, and sustains our faith. Reflection ko, in a nutshell, I need to depend on God more than ever. Ah, oh my gosh. Oh, I guess one of the reasons why I say this then is because, I think that this year, sobrang hirap for me in terms of growing in my faith, walking with God. It's been very challenging this whole year, and part of it then siguro has been because of my mindset or yung mga habits ko dahil sa sobrang dami na mga nangyari. It's as if they fell. As in, madami akong mga good habits na nawala. Like habits that I built to keep over the last few years. And isa na dun yung Bible reading that has been affected and in prayer. Ayun nga, when we were going through 2 Thessalonians, finally realized ko din that when we are trying to follow God's will, it becomes really hard, and we are very susceptible to attacks in that way, I think. So in my case naman, in the case of the Thessalonians, it's evil or wicked people who may want to attack Sina Paul from doing what he was called to do in spreading the gospel. So meron din yung discouragement that the Thessalonians were going through that has made them idle and kept them from doing what they were supposed to do. So we encounter all sorts of difficulties. And in the end, it really is the Lord who's faithful. Like, even if we are not, or even if we fail, at the end of the day, He's the one who's faithful, and He's the one who strengthens us, who protects us. And siguro nga, I may have been overconfident din in my own abilities to the point that sometimes, parang nawawalan ako ng reliance kay God. In the sense na parang wala, kasi parang lalo na sa faith, it's a struggle for me because I always have to fight this mindset na alam ko na yan parang like I always have to fight this mindset that I already know things, when the fact that I'm already thinking that is a roadblock or is an obstacle in itself for growing deeper in my faith. Tapos last Sunday nga, I had to attend this, we had this thing in church called Coffee and God Basta it's like some sort of ano ba siya? Parang talk din, parang going through yung foundational steps that we are going to teach those that we disciple. So very simple yung format sa church namin. It's ano yun? Parang point number one is kung sino si God, and then two yung identity, and number three oh my goodness, I forgot number three. Pero the point is, mayroong isang portion dun that describe like what the gospel is. And the gospel essentially is, di ba, yung finished work of Christ. And when we do things, yung sinasabi, pero sinabi dun sa ano na yun, sa workshop na yun, like when we do things without the gospel of Christ in mind, it's in danger of turning into moralism. So meaning to say na ano na lang siya, parang we do things simply because it's rooted in our pride or just doing things na parang nagiging legalism na din siya, and I'm like, oh no, I've fallen into that trap. So it's like, anyway, going back, I'm just reminded of how much I really, really need to depend on God, even in times where I think na, ay, kaya ko yan. Kaya ko yan, or kaya ko to. Kasi, the truth of the matter is, I can't. And it's in these times where I've been struggling in my faith scenario, for maintaining, you know, what I believe I built, that I realized, you know, it's not in my own strength, but it really is in Christ. The reason why I do things is because of Him. It's not about feeling great or being accomplished or doing things simply because they are to be done. But I should not lose sight of who Christ is, and that it is He who directs my faith, or He is the reason why I walk to begin with. So I'm not sure kung medyo related at all, pero that's my reflection, at least in terms of where I am. So as for application, simple lang din. I will read the Bible at least, I will take at least 10 minutes a day to listen for God's voice for the next week. And it's actually something that I've been doing again these past few days. As in, what I would do is I would try to practice total silence and just wait for God to impress anything, if anything at all. And so far, I feel that God is speaking to me then through it. So I want to continue this habit lang. So I'm praying na isa din siya sa mga re-established na habits. Because honestly, praying, madali sa akin magbasa ng Bible, but it's praying that I really struggle with and actually trying to hear God or like be still and be quiet. Dun talaga ako nagsa-struggle kasi I always have this need to feel that I'm doing something, I'm being productive. Pero, ayun yan. God is trying to teach me how to wait and be still in this season, I think. Yun lang for me. Thank you very much.
Ate Jim, ano ang connection ng application mo sa homiletical idea?
Sorry?
Ano ang connection ng application mo sa homiletical idea?
Because I need to rely on God. Because
okay.
Eh, medyo hindi lang nagko-connect dito unless I really like outright explain it. Pero ayun nga kasi I have this mindset nga na alam ko 'yan or alam ko na 'yan. Okay, let's just read this. Tapos eh nahihirapan talaga ako mag-sit still. For him. When in the first place, that's hearing God's will in things is how he sustains our faith. Because apart from listening from his voice, you're just doing things. You're relying on your understanding or your acting out of what you already know. Yung tipong ganun. I'm not sure if I was able to explain it well, pero that's how I connect it in my mind. I need to listen for his will talaga. I need to listen for his will and I need to rely more on him to sustain my faith rather than me just reading when I would not allow him to let things sink into my heart, or I would not allow him to I would not give him time to really tell me what to do.
Listening to God's voice is a form of reliance, or siguro to be is an expression of dependence on God, and it is how God sustains our faith. It is through listening. Tapos dito naman natin, at least 10 minutes, so parang magta-timer ka sa sarili mo. Tama ba?
Yeah, actually my timer nga. Like I keep this timer in my desk. On ko lang camera ko. Ito siya oh.
Alam mo, ganyan din ako, Ate Jean, pero mas basic lang yung sa akin. Hindi siya 6 buttons. Tatlong buttons lang siya.
Ayoko kasi gamitin yung cellphone ko kasi mas madali ako ma-distract. So, I have separate timer that I use. Last, sinaset ko to, 10 minutes. You know, just to keep in silence. And, yun. Kasi kung nasa ko siya, madidistract talaga ako. So, it's a habit that I'm trying to build again these past few days. And so far, I think it's bearing its fruit naman.
Mm-hmm.
Ayun.
So, ano na lang, sorry. Saan mo gagawin ito, Ate? Can you specify where you will listen for God's voice? Pati how din pala.
How
do you listen to God's voice? Like through reading the Bible or praying or meditating? Paano it's pala itong...
Ah, kasi it's really in keeping quiet. As in, so, di ba, I would read the Bible, I would pray, tapos I would spend 10 minutes just being quiet. And okay. Siguro I would ask maybe yes or no questions. Kaya na, God, what do you want me to do? Do you, is this a good thing or a bad thing? So maybe yes, maybe no. So this is usually my time to try to ask very specific things from God.
Mm-hmm.
Na hindi mo naman basta-basta mababasa sa Bible.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, meron naman, yes, of course. May mga guidelines, ganun. Pero this is usually the time where I would try to really quiet my thoughts.
Mm.
Tapos, if anything is impressed on me, like a verse or anything really, I would look into that. Tapos, yun. It's something else aside from reading the Bible. Reading what I am scheduled to read for the day. So, parang ganun siya. I think I borrowed some of these principles from Dallas Willard din sa book niya na Hearing from God.
Hearing God?
Yeah, Hearing God. Sorry.
I love that book talaga.
Yeah. But it's just so hard to keep God.
So, what if, ano na lang? I will take at least 10 minutes a day to be silent.
Ah, okay.
Ask God questions and listen for His voice. Something like that.
Ah, so gusto mo mas specific. Yeah, that.
Oo. Para hindi siya, wala bang vagueness na maiiwan?
Okay, edi type na. Be quiet. Ask God questions, directions for life, and listen for
his, God's voice.
Yeah. Yan. So, minsan wala, as in, minsan wala talaga ako nakukuha, and I'm like, ah, okay. But at least I tried. Pero minsan talaga, merong very specific verses or direction. Very rarely, but it's something that I think is worth listening for them.
So, linagay ko na siya sa ano, sa parang BTM application, as you can see here. So, sa May para for the chart. Sa,
bye, Jens.
Bye, Jens.
Bye, Ate. Kuya Obed. Sorry, di kayo na ko ma-expound ang ako.
Sige lang, you can just chat in the group chat if you have time.
Okay. Bye.
Thank you, Jens, for joining us.
Bye.
So, linagay ko siya sa Google Sheets ate, tapos she just put not done. Correct. Para scary. Charon. Tapos, light blue na lang siguro. So, ito yung legend. So, for example, na
per day talaga siya. Oh my gosh.
Kasi for the next weekend, sabi mo? For the next week?
Sige na nga. Alright. Okay.
It's fine. Bakit nangyari dito?
Kaya natin white na text. Now, there we go.
Legend.
Ayun.
So, for example, nagawa mo siya ng May 15. So, ganyan na siya. Ganyan. Kasi per ano eh, for the first week. Pero pag hindi mo siya ano, makikita natin, bakit hindi mo nagawa nung May 16, ganun. Ah, kasi na-busy ka, ganun. How can you remind yourself better, ganun. Maganda siya for me. Tsaka visual siya eh. Ewan ko lang, siguro visual ako masyado na person.
Ano yung hehehe na yun?
Where pala, Ate Jean? Hindi mo nalagay ang ano?
Usually sa bahay, sa room ko.
Where specifically sa room?
Sa desk ko. Usually.
At my desk.
Yeah. I think it's the best place. Kasi may tendency akong makatulog if I do it while lying down. Yeah. If I listen while lying down. Kasi pipikit ako eh.
Oh. One place, one function, di ba? That's yeah. One.
Although I've tried to listen for God's voice naman while lying down in bed. Pero, may danger nga talaga na makatulog ako.
May 14 to 20 ang linagay ni ano ni Jensen, pero tapos na ang 14.
Today is 14.
Oh, after waking up eh. Nakagising na siya.
Ah, okay.
Lagay ko na lang ano. Tapos hanggang 21 lang shooting. Yarn. O di ba? It's the very good talaga. Ewan ko lang, na-appreciate mo bang ganito? Kasi mas ma-hold mo ang each other accountable. Kasi talagang actionable siya, actually. Kaya lang, di na natin siya napa-explain, ano?
Well, I think it's a good way to go. Tamad ako, but I think that's all the more reason I need it.
Yung ano, ito?
Well, I mean, you know, challenging yourself with an application. Kasi, di ba, usually, pag, kahit nga sa mga small groups namin, right, we would talk about what we learn, tapos, you know, things that we want to do. Pero it doesn't necessarily mean na gagawin namin. So, I think with this, it would help, it would really help, everyone do yeah. What he said that they're going to do. Ikaw ba?
Hindi na ako mag-share. Okay na yun sa inyo. Okay na yun. Mag-ano na tayo? Mag
ay hindi tayo